Good morning. Happy Sabbath.
To start a service, Jewel and I would like to read a wonderful passage to prepare our hearts for our worship today. May this reading help us feel the presence of God and praise Him. Praise His name. O give thanks to the Lord, call upon His name, make known His deeds among the peoples.
Sing to Him, sing praises to Him, speak of all His wonders.
Glory in His holy name. Let the heart of those who seek the Lord be glad. Seek the Lord and His strength. Seek His face continually.
Remember His wonders which He has done, His marvels and the judgments uttered by His mouth. O seed of Abraham, His servant, O sons of Jacob, His chosen ones.
He is the Lord our God. His judgments are all the earth. He has remembered His covenant forever, the word which He commanded to a thousand generations.
Please stand.
Happy Sabbath, dear family and friends. Our scripture reading for today is found in the book of John, chapter 6, verses 53 to 55, and verse 63. And I am going to read from the New King James Version. Then Jesus said to them, "Most assuredly I say to you, unless you eat flesh of the Son of Man, and drink His blood, you have no life in you. Whoever eats My flesh and drinks My blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. For My flesh is food indeed, and My blood is drink indeed. It is the Spirit who gives life. The flesh profits nothing. The words that I speak to you are spirit, and they are life. Let us pray. Almighty God, thank you that we are able to continue to worship you. We praise you, Lord, for being our great God, who loved us so much that you sent your only Son, Jesus, to die on the cross so that we might have eternal life with him. We come to you, Lord, as sinners. Please forgive us and fill us with your Holy Spirit. I pray for our Loma in the Filipino church family, including many others, those who are sick and recovering, those who are grieving because of the loss of loved ones, those who are discouraged and struggling because of this pandemic time. Dear Lord, please embrace them with your loving arms. Thank you for the hope and comfort. And now I lift up to you, Lord, Pastor Manalo, as he delivers us your message, how to live forever. It is our desire to be among your people in the new earth, Father God, where there will be no more suffering nor death. Please help us to prepare for your soon coming. Thank you for the assurance of your word. Thank you for your blessings. In Jesus' holy name I pray. Amen.
Good morning and happy Sabbath. It is time to worship God through giving. From the book of 1 Chronicles, chapter 29, verses 11 to 13, I will read from the New International Version. Yours, Lord, is the greatness and the power, and the glory and the majesty and the splendor. For everything in heaven and earth is yours. Yours, Lord, is the kingdom. You are exalted as head over all. Wealth and honor come from you. You are the ruler of all things. In your hands are strength and power to exalt and give strength to all. Now, our God, we give you thanks and praise your glorious name. Our offering this Sabbath is for the Pacific Union Conference. In addition to this special offering, please remember in your giving our local church budget. Although we don't meet physically in our church facility, we are still committed to pay our monthly bills, to pay for water, electricity, mortgage, and maintenance fees. We will need your support in this regard. There are three ways in giving your tithes and offerings. The first option is to give online through our website, llfc.org/give. The second option is to write a check and mail it to Loma Linda Filipino Church, P.O. Box 579, Loma Linda, California, 92354. The third option is if you choose to use your credit card, you may call the treasurer in this number, 909-653-5444. Thank you for your generous support. Shall we bow our heads for prayer? Our eternal God and loving Heavenly Father, you own the cattle on the thousand hills. You own all the silver and gold. But thank you for allowing us to partner with you in blessing others through our monetary contribution. Thank you, Father, that in the midst of this pandemic, you are still in control on all the affairs of the world. Thank you for the commitment of your children, for their being faithful stewards of the resources that you have entrusted to them. Bless these tithes and offerings that we will receive. Multiply it and extend its reach and influence. May God's abundant grace be upon the members and friends of Loma Linda Filipino Church. Prosper them in health, bless them in their means of livelihood, but above all, Father, keep them steadfast to the faith until the return of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, for hearing and answering our prayers. This I ask in the precious name of Jesus, with the forgiveness of our sins. And all the people said, Amen.
Thank you. morning and a happy Sabbath. I believe all of us enjoy going out eating or eating in our at our homes, and we have favorite menus, favorite dish. So what's your favorite dish? Do you enjoy eating spaghetti? Do you enjoy eating adobo? Do you enjoy eating salad? Do you enjoy eating barbecue? So what's your favorite menu, or what's your favorite dish? Or what's on your menu? We eat because we want to extend our physical life and we want to maintain our health. And precisely, we don't want to miss any meal during the day as much as possible. And we also drink because we know that we need the water in and outside of our body, especially inside of our body, so that our body will be cleansed. There will be regularity in our excretion of fluids to cleanse our organs. So eating and drinking are very, very essential for our health and for our life. And the kind of food that we eat will also determine by and large the quality of life that we live. However, in all our eating, whether we enjoy going to a Korean cuisine or Korean restaurant or Italian cuisine, there's always a favorite that we want to eat. But today, did you know that there is a menu, there is a dish that when we eat, according to the Bible and according to Jesus Christ, we will never die? Jesus Christ said that he who eats my flesh and drinks my blood will live forever, will live without dying. When Jesus Christ said this to his listeners, the day before, he fed them. There were 5,000 of them who were fed from the 5 loaves of bread and 2 pieces of fish. And the people enjoyed the food that Jesus Christ provided for them right there in the desert. It was getting late in the day, and Jesus Christ saw the people who were following him, listening to him all day, and he had compassion on them, and he told his disciples to give them something to eat. And so, Jesus Christ gave them something to eat, and they were all fed, and they were all satisfied. The following day, they were looking for Jesus. And knowing that when the disciples left the shore where they were fed with the food, they saw that Jesus Christ was not with them. So the following day, they were looking for him. And there were available boats, and there were some who walked by land, and they must have walked fast because they reached the place where Jesus was ahead of time of those who have boarded some boats. And when they saw Jesus Christ, they asked him, "Teacher, when did you come here?" And then Jesus Christ told them, "You are seeking me, or you are looking for me, not because you understood the sign but because you ate and you were satisfied. And then Jesus Christ told them, do not work or do not labor, do not toil for the food that perishes, but toil for the food that will last you forever. And I am going to give you that food. And if you eat this food, this bread, and drink my blood, you will no longer hunger, you will no longer be thirsty. Then the people said to Jesus Christ, Lord, give us this food always. And then Jesus Christ said, I am the bread of life who came down from heaven. And the people said, how could this be? We know in our history that when the people of Israel were in the wilderness, Moses gave them manna from heaven. And the manna kept on pouring during the day, early morning, and the manna supplied them for food for 40 years when they were traveling across the wilderness on their way to the promised land. And then Jesus Christ told them, it was not really Moses who gave you that food from heaven. It was his Father, the Father of Jesus, or God the Father, who gave the food. And he said that the real food, the real bread that came down from heaven was in their midst. And Jesus Christ told them, he who believes in me will live forever. And you know, the people had some difficulty in accepting this because they knew the parents of Jesus Christ and they also knew his brothers and sisters. They were familiar. And so they asked Jesus Christ, or they murmured, grumbled among themselves. They said, how can this man give us his flesh to eat and his blood to drink? And then Jesus Christ again reiterated, anyone who eats of this bread, he will live forever. And the bread that I shall give is my flesh, which I shall give for the life of the world. Jesus Christ here is intimating, he is trying to open their minds that the food that he is going to give them, that if they received by faith will result into their having eternal life, is his own life, his body that he was going to give. And how alone can he give his body? By dying and by pouring his blood at Calvary. And Jesus said this in many different ways. He said, he who believes in me has everlasting life. Then he said, he who eats of this bread will live forever. And then he again says that he who eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life. And then he says, he who feeds on me will live because of me. And then he who eats this bread will live forever. So you can see here, brothers and sisters, that believing in Jesus Christ is the same as eating his flesh and blood. And eating and drinking is also the same as abiding in him. Because as you see, brothers and sisters, what happens when we eat, for example, rice or bread? When we eat the food that we put into our body, the food that we eat will become part of us. And we, are sustained by the life-giving nutrients of the food that we take in by eating. And also the water that we drink also contributes to our life, our everyday life. And then Jesus Christ made this daily occurrence or occurrences of eating and drinking as illustrations in how to have eternal life. So, dearly beloved, to have eternal life is not very complicated if we believe in Jesus Christ, and I do believe that we believe in Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ says, you want eternal life? You eat me. You drink me. You drink my blood. You believe in me. You trust me. You come to me. You abide with me and in me. And the life that I have, Jesus Christ was telling to them, is the life that you shall receive. Again, just like the nutrients from the food that we eat, giving us life-giving nutrients, sustaining our life, extending our existence. The difference between what we physically eat and drink is that the food that we eat physically and the drink or the water that we drink physically, they will only sustain and extend our biological, physical existence. However, the life that Jesus Christ imparts to us when we accept Him as our personal Savior and Lord, when we believe Him, when we trust Him, when we give our lives to Him, ourselves to Him, so that we in return will receive Him into our lives by faith. The life that He gives to us, according to Jesus Himself, is eternal life. A life that will last forever. I notice, dearly beloved, that generally, men and women want to live longer. And what is the proof of this? When a person gets sick, he goes to a doctor. Why does he go to a doctor? Because he wants to receive the treatment. And why does he want to receive the treatment? So that his sickness or his disease may be cured. And why does he want to be cured? So that he may get well again. In other words, he will go back to his normal kind or way of life. So all of us, whether young and old, all of us want to live longer. And that is not, there's nothing wrong in wanting and desiring to live longer. But dearly beloved, in all our desires to live longer, so that we may enjoy fellowshipping with our loved ones, so that we may enjoy continually to eat and to drink, and so that we may also enjoy traveling, visiting places that we have never seen, there's nothing wrong in these desires. Maybe these are also God-given desires to make us enjoy life and be happy. However, let us not forget that there is a kind of food that we should eat if we want and if we desire and decide to live forever, to live without end. And this is Jesus Christ. And you know, the people, when they were listening to Jesus Christ, they had a hard time understanding Him. So Jesus Christ explained it and made it more simple. He said to them, when the people thought that Jesus Christ was literally telling them to eat his flesh and drink his blood, thus suggesting that they become cannibals, Jesus Christ disabused their minds. And he explained it to them. He said in John 6:63, "It is the Spirit who gives life. The flesh profits nothing. The words that I speak to you are spirit, and they are life." Oh, that is the secret. That is the formula. If we want to eat the flesh of Jesus Christ and drink his blood, we do this by eating his words. And Jesus Christ said, "The words that I speak to you, they are full of life. They are spirit, and they are full of life." Okay, let's see. When we eat the bread or the rice, what do we do? We chew. We put it into our mouth. We chew. We mix it with our saliva. We enjoy the taste. And then, after we shall have grounded or grinded the food into smaller, fine pieces, we swallow. Do we worry whether the food that we have eaten or swallowed will supply the nutrients, the life-giving nutrients to our bodies? We don't. We don't have control. As long as we eat the food, our body will receive the nutrients, the life-giving nutrients. The same is true when we read the Bible. We chew it. Those big chunks of truth, we break them into smaller pieces by analyzing them. We process them through our minds, enlightened by the Holy Spirit. And when we believe, we trust the words of Jesus Christ, and that is the same as trusting in him, because his words are not separable from his person, then the life that Jesus has, we shall receive into our souls. That's why Jesus Christ says, "Because I live, you too will live." And you know, Ellen White says in one of her writings that the life of God is in the Word itself. So that when we receive the Word into our lives, into our minds, and into our hearts, and we live by them, then we receive the life of God, which is eternal life. So, dearly beloved, I'll ask you once more, what's on your menu? Adobo? Ginisa? Salad? Sarsiado? Apitado? What's on your menu? What mix do you enjoy the best when you cook and prepare the meal for yourself and for your family? Let us not forget. Let us remember that Jesus Christ, when he was here on earth, he said to those who were listening to him and by extension to us, "Unless you eat my flesh and drink my blood, you have no life in you. But anyone who eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life. And because I live," Jesus Christ said, "you too will live." And then Jesus Christ added, for those who were listening to him, "Your ancestors ate the manna in the wilderness, but they were all dead. They all died. And nobody could argue with Jesus Christ, because there was no one, no Israel, no Israelites who was in the wilderness, who was in their midst during that day. They were all dead by the time Jesus Christ told this to them. But then Jesus Christ again said, "The food, the bread that I give to you is not like that manna. Whereas that manna has sustained the Israelites for 40 years in the wilderness, and they died. This food that I'm going to give you after I die on the cross, and when I rise from the grave, this will last you for eternity. You will have a life that will not end. And even if you die the physical death, your life will be hid with God in Christ. That when Jesus Christ will come, He will raise you back to life. He will confer upon you and upon me immortality and life everlasting in His presence. How good is the Lord! How loving is our God! He wants to spend eternity with us. Won't you eat the flesh and drink His blood by reading His word, by believing His words, by obeying His words, and allowing Him to abide with you and in you, and you in Him, so that even in this earth, while we are still journeying, going to heaven, we can now enjoy the life of Jesus Christ, the life eternal. May God bless us, and may God continually feed us. May God continually protect us, and may God continue to walk with us as we move day by day, getting closer and closer on our way to heaven.
Thank you for joining us at Loma de la Filipina Church during our worship service. May this worship service be an opportunity to each one of you to truly give honor and praise to our wonderful God. Before we end, just a few reminders. On June 20, it will be our graduation Sabbath. So if you are a graduate of the year 2020, you are a kindergarten, an eighth grader, a high schooler, a college, or even in a graduate studies, please join us on that time. And the way to join is to send your photo and also your name and your school that you graduated to Lily Lion, and just send that to the email that you'll be seeing on the screen right now. Also, just a reminder to also continue to connect with us. And there are different ways on how to connect with us. First is you can connect with us through the YouTube channel. If you are watching the YouTube channel, you will see an icon on the right lower corner, and click on that icon and you will see subscribe. Hit that so that you can subscribe. Another option is to go to your internet browser and type in llfc.org, and then when you press enter, you will go to the website, our Loma Linda Filipino Church website, and you will see different things there, like our events and different news and announcements. Also, it's an opportunity for you to find the online giving link. So just look for that giving tab and you will see that link. Click on that and it will lead you to Adventist giving, and you will be able to give to Loma Linda Filipino Church. Just really a reminder that we are ongoingly, you know, having some events online for our young kids, for young life, for our high school, teenagers, youth, and also even our collegiate.
And also, we do have also Sabbath school previews. And for all those information, you can go to either our website or contact our office at Loma Linda Filipino Church. Looking forward to seeing you next week, and happy Sabbath to all of you.